was a pretty wayward start from Jamie Overton, who, if you remember, late last evening sent. No third man. And the pace of Overton, the speed of the outfield takes that racing away and brings Tom Blundell another half century in what is an excellent series for him. Trying to play into that plan again, but Blundell this time rolling his wrists, keeping the ball down. There's very few of those bowlers, mind you, that can rattle it above 90 miles an hour like gold dust. Tom Blundell. DRS is down. Blundell cannot review. The umpire's decision stands. What do you think of the LBW, Mel?
I was dubious to start with. I thought he might have got a little inside edge on it.
Down the ground, not far from broad, but being round the wicket, he couldn't get to it. And Bracewell, who loves hitting boundaries, is off the mark with one. Hit hard, just nailed through mid-wicket. It was flatter and quicker from Leach, and it went like a rocket off the bat.
Oh, he does take the man on and just gets enough of it. Only just. Oh, it's worked.
That reaction tells you all you need to know.
Very good bowling again from Stuart Broad. This one's just hot, held its line a touch. Good catch, Zach Crawley, straight into those big mitts. England have finally held on to one.
In the air that little bit longer. Golfers out there will know. Downhill, the ball travels further. Best, I thought he had it cut. Oh, Tim Southey. Well, that'll wake a few up in the Western Terrace.
Straight over Ben Foulkes' head for four. There is a fly slip in place.
Yeah, he's been bumped out three times in the series.
Not only sixes either, but fours as well. He deals in boundaries. Mitchell likes to take it on as well and does so superbly on this occasion. And arms aloft, Darrell Mitchell goes to 100, the first New Zealand batsman to go to 300s in successive test matches against England. He's playing quite magnificently. Full toss and the full extension of the arms from Mitchell, who has just pumped Jamie Overton back over. Southey smears it away. Stokes hasn't picked it up and I don't think we'll be able to cut it off. He would have been able to cut it off had he picked it up off the bat, but he didn't. Excellent from Southey. Overton went for the Yorker for the final ball of the over. Southey backing away, expecting the short ball. Kept his eyes on it, hit it beautifully through point, 317%. God! Stokes. Excellent from Ben Stokes. Both the captaincy and the catching. Right before lunch, he dangled that carrot for Darrell Mitchell. Leach came back round.
Go again if you want, and he did. And England's best catcher was in the right place at the right time.
Very nice shot from Neil Wagner. That is as good as we've seen, actually. We're in the 117th over.
Oh, that's gone straight up in the air. Ben Stokes positions himself underneath it. Jack Leach has four. And England have their ninth. The back end of the New Zealand innings.
Yeah, it just doesn't push those fielders back. Three men round the bat and a bit of rough for Leach to aim into. as Wagner goes down the ground. Bairstow. Oh, brilliant from Johnny Bairstow. Right in front of the old Western Terrace. And they stand and rise to him. They enjoyed that moment.
First thought was that Wagner had got a really decent piece of this and it was going to go sailing into the stand at the football ground end. Johnny Bairstow turned and ran back and then realised, hang on a second, it's not going to make it. Changed direction twice, then had to sprint to his left.
Oh, down it goes. It went very quickly to Daryl Mitchell at first slip. Oh, wow. What an over this is from Trent Bolt. He has had Lees dropped, he's beaten him all ends up, and now he's castled him with an absolute peach.
Well, this series, it does not disappoint. A quiet day by its standards yesterday. But it's been all action today. This is just perfect. You talk about it, they practice it, top of off stump, hit the top of off stump. Thing they don't mention is getting the ball.
It's a little uppish, slight leading edge from Zach Crawley, who was looking to work Saudi to leg it. Timed very sweetly by Ollie Pope. Just a bit of curve from Trent Bolt.
That is a peach. He's done it once, he's done it twice. How many more times will he do it? He's up for it here, Trent Bolt. And England in trouble early.
From Ollie Pope. Back through that gap. He didn't get across far enough to off stump. Played around that front pad. Back through the gate. Rips off pole out of the ground.
Once again, it is just a pleasure to watch if you love swing bowling. And this one's even brought a smile to his face.
But he's reaching, he's searching. And he's just nowhere. Lovely swing and seam bowling again from Trent Bolt. He's picked up another, his third, and England in further trouble.
Oh. That's nice too. He wants to chip in here to Southie. It is a masterclass of bowling from New Zealand. Southie chips in. Bolt's doing his work. And New Zealand well and truly on top.
Angle in. Draws Joe Root into playing that shot. Little edge. Tom Blundell does the rest.
Here's the full one. Johnny Bairstow, up to the challenge though. Yes. And again, even better. The form continues for Johnny Bairstow as he gets into his innings. 31 for 4. You've got something else for us now.
Across the seam.
Well, I said it's a kind of occasion and that he might thrive in, might enjoy. I think that's the answer.
And this is a classic case of coming in and deciding how you want to play. And this is not something you probably expect in a test match when you're 4 wickets down, but it is the captain, and that's kind of making a statement as to how he thinks that he's going to try and put England.
And just enough elevation. I say in the game, they were nearly there, just about to take wicket number 5, but Johnny Bairstow with enough bat speed. Brave and rewarded for being brave, and a huge cheer from the Western Terrace. They're enjoying for now what they're seeing from England's captain. Beautiful shot. That is quite brilliant. You'll see that on the replay, that what he does so well. I think he's thinking about blasting this back down the ground, but in the end he just makes a late adjustment. Gets lucky. Johnny Bairstow gets lucky. Inside edge. Nothing that Blundell could do. He's not quite going his way. He'd be happy enough with the scoreboard, though. 55 for 4. Surely out. Yes, simple catch. Joy for Wagner. Back in the side. You can see the emotion. England are now 5 down. Ben Stokes has gone.
earlier on for the other batters. Stokes again using his feet, not really up to the ball, a little bit of swing, the bat turning in his hand.
Big swing, back in and given, finger is raised. Further problems for England, I think. Ben Foulkes is saying, no, I'll have a look at that.
Third and batting director. Player review for LBW. Original decision is out. It's a fair delivery. We want to spin win, please. Yes. You want to spin? Make your signal.
Yeah, well, you can see why Ben Foulkes might have hoped. I think it was more in hope than judgment. Again, going for swing, not quite as much. This time more angled across. And Jamie Overton just threads it through extra cover. Nice start for the debutant.
That'll find the gap. Johnny Bairstow is still ticking from Trent Pritchard. Shot. England still up with the rate. Nicked and gone. Overton reviews. Mariah Erasmus gave him out on field. Overton doesn't think he's touched it. He might have hit the floor.
When ball past the bat, you need to reverse your decision. You're on screen.
DRS is in play, thankfully.
Through the gap for four. Wonderful piece of timing and a race away.
Beautifully played. So much in control.
That is a very, very good looking drive from Jamie Overton. Brings up the 50 partnership between he and Johnny Bairstow. Oh, a little bit uppish, but down through a wide gully. And into the boundary for four more.
He is nicely bent, which means he's able to keep his momentum going forward.
Very good, Mark, as is that shot from Johnny Bairstow. He goes to 50. Lovely shot. Lovely shot. Just punched down the ground as he does, Johnny Bairstow. A fine sweep. It's not the slog sweep, it's the fine sweep. And he gets the boundary.
Yes, yes, yes.
Lovely shot. There is a sweeper there, but Bairstow's nailed it for four. It's been a little bit short. He's bowled it into the pitch and Bairstow's pulled that away for four. And the pitch, big shot, big shot all the way for six, his first six in Test match cricket
this afternoon and now this evening as Bairstow clubs Wagner over mid on. Pummeled away into the leg side by Jamie Overton, who goes to 50 on debut. Clubbed away into the Western Terrace by Overton.
Gets it through, back-to-back hundreds for the first time in Johnny Bairstow's career, his second at his home ground here at Headingley.
Just clipped to the man in the deep. Johnny Bairstow will have strike first up tomorrow morning. He ends on 130, Overton on 89. Another truly remarkable day of Test match cricket.